what song food challenge would I set? Well, funnily enough, I did set it for myself, but not properly. For the final round where I would have gone against the master, but I had to make up a challenge for myself because I thought you guys deserved to have a final song instead of just saying, yeah, I'm master of Song Fu, yay. I thought, you know, I've got to do a song. So I gave myself a week, and because my first ever challenge was write a happy song, I thought, well, for this I'll write a sad song. It's not write a sad song that I would choose as a challenge. It would be write a serious song, a song with no humorous content whatsoever, you know? Not tongue-in-cheek, not satirical, well, it could be satirical, I suppose, but nothing humorous, nothing that would make anybody go away going, that was funny. Just a song which is serious, frankly. That's why we choose. Yay! I'm the master now! That's probably not what you want, is it? Challenging. Difficult. Exciting. Scary. Sarah Parsons. I've collaborated with Borba Spinotti, I collaborated with Colleen, I collaborated with Paul Potts on at least two of my songs. I tried to do a few Christmas numbers with Edric Haleen, but he bottled on me and did his own Christmas album instead. Found that strange. I've made no bones about it. I love collaborating, so, you know, I don't know if I could point to specific people and say who would collaborate well with who, because that in itself can be a challenge. I just want to know why nobody has got in touch with me and said, hey Joe, would you like to help me with this? Or, hey Joe, would you like to work together on this? Just don't do it. Why is that? Answers. The actual writing process of getting the... It varies from song to song, it really does. I have been known to, you know, I've been asked to write a song. I've picked up my drum and have written the song while I sung it. I'm not too bad at that. Stuff like that. I'm very good at speed poetry. So in much the same way, depending on what I'm singing, I'm pretty good at speed songs as well. As long as it's, you know, rudimentary, because we're talking, you know, just get the baron, hammer out a beat, sing the song, and have a, you know, something akin to a traditional tune going through my head, but, you know, something that's unique, obviously, or at least semi-original. For something like Song Fu, where there's a little bit more thought going into it, I think probably something along the lines of 48 to 72 hours, maybe, because I don't have all day to sit and work on them unless I get the weekend, but even then, you know, it's the weekend. It's the only time I do have off. So I would say overall, probably 48 to 72 hours work goes into a song for Song Fu, for me, roughly. I record my songs any number of ways, really. I've got a large digital audio workstation, which basically has a few outputs, but to be honest, I only use two inputs. One is my microphone, which is a Behringer B1, and the other is the cable to plug in my guitar or my bass guitar on my acoustic, which is can also be plugged straight into the box. That's run by FireWire straight into my PC. I generally record into and mix in Mixcraft 4. and advise people to check out Mixcraft 4 because it's very good. If there's any problems with the finished WAV file that I export, I then use Sonic Foundry and port it into Sonic Foundry, and I go through it to check for any, you know, like maybe pops or ticks or peaks, because they that can iron them up quite well. Mixing them again, as I said, it's all through Mixcraft. It's mixing's a laborious process, and I do again tend to get a wee bit slapdash. I know that there are people out there that will, you know, they'll say, "Oh, I've got this song and I've been working on it for ages and ages and ages. I just can't do that," which is probably why I don't mind Song Fu so much, because that's the way that I'm used to writing. When I get an idea, it's like, I want to do it now! So I just really like throw it up, mix it, yeah, that's good enough, put it out there. And that's how I work. I suppose if it was going to be, you know, my job, if this was going to be something that I do, which it isn't, you know, I've done that, I've been there. I'm 46 years old now, my time for being an internet superstar or anything similar has long passed me. I've done the professional performer, and I'm now frankly too old to do that, and I need stability. So I'm quite happy with how I mix things. It's good enough for my purposes, which are to get a song, get it down there, let people hear it, and maybe bring somebody some enjoyment. Absolutely, yes. It's a straightforward answer. The straightforward answer is yes. How? If you go to joecovenant.bandcamp.com. One of my albums is called Shadowland, and what that is, it's a lot of songs written as if I was a warrior bard from, you know, the time of the Vikings, frankly, because that's who I have made those albums as. I am a Viking bard when I'm singing those songs, when I'm writing those songs, and pretty much all that is on those, in fact, not pretty much all that is on those, guitar, baron, a few sound effects, because it just runs all the way through. It's split up into individual songs, obviously, but it's got a theme running all the way through it, with sound effects leading from one song into the next. I quite like the way I've put it together, to be quite honest. But the actual main track, Shadowland, screams to have a string section behind it. It really does scream to me. I can hear, it's going back to the hearing, you know, there's nothing more frustrating. I can hear it all in my head, and for the life of me, there is no way that I could do it. I used to have access to a string quartet on the It's My Dundee album, same place. If you listen to a few tracks on there, you can hear the string section that I was able to get a hold of, and we multi-tracked them. So that it sounds like a much bigger session, whereas there was only four or five of them. They weren't actually a quartet, they were an ensemble. If you listen to It's My Dundee album, both the track It's My Dundee and The Road and the Miles to Dundee, they kind of give you an idea of where I would go if I had access to more times, because that was actually recorded in a full studio with access to a lot of other musicians. I can't do it now, frankly, because that was done as a project for Dundee Football Club, and the person who owned the studio, he and I made the album together. I did all of the writing, really, all the singing, most of the music, but to break it up, we did need other musicians. He, being the owner of the studio, knew an awful lot of people, asked them if they'd like to come in on it, and they did. So that's basically it. Yeah, the short answer, obviously, is yes, but I think everybody would, really.